Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations. Today I have the HPE ProLiant DL20 Gen11 server powered by a single Intel Xeon 6 processor. It's a compact short depth platform that makes it a shoe-in for near edge, edge, remote or branch offices, a point of sale platform, and other space constrained environments. Even for government work, which is probably not a good selling point these days. Like our channel, then hit that subscribe button, like you're playing whack-a-mole. Let's get to it. As one of the more budget-friendly servers, the HPE ProLiant DL20 Gen11 still delivers enterprise-class performance. You've got ease of deployment, advanced security features with ILO Advanced, and at just a hair over 15 inches in depth, it can fit just about anywhere. New on this system is support for an Intel Xeon 6300P CPU with performance or P cores. Also a 13th generation Intel Xeon E2400 series CPU, codenamed Raptor Lake. The previous generation could be outfitted with an Intel Xeon E2200 series processor, Pentium, or 9th generation Core i3 processor. The Intel Xeon 6 is a definite improvement. The tradition continues on this new platform as there is room for a single Pentium on the Gen 11 system. The thing I do like about that 9th generation Core i3 processor is the codename, Coffee Lake. Wouldn't that be nice? The front of the system features HPE's first shooter game target bezel with green targeting frame in the center. I like it. It has a Kensington lock slot on the left. The system is so small you could basically carry it out like a laptop, so security features are welcome. After removing the front bezel, there are options for storage, either two hot plug or two non-hot plug 3.5 inch drive bays, or 4 plus 2 hot plug SFF bays. The plus 2 is for the media bay in the upper left. It can be outfitted with an optional 2 SFF drive carrier, optional optical drive, or nothing but a perforated panel. The perforated panel on the other side hides 2 intake fans. Are you interested in this cute as a button HPE ProLiant DL20 Gen 11 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can get up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. If that sounds like a sweet deal, then just mention this video when you're ready to make a purchase. Maybe your dog needs a friend. The control panel in the middle features a removable panel for an optional boot device. Then the power on button, health status LED, NIC status LED, and a unit ID button with integrated LED. Next to those, an ILO service port on top and USB 3.2 Gen 1 port on the bottom. The back of the system has a single PSU on the right with the option to install a second for redundancy. Next to that, a PCI slot on top and OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot below. Then a knockout panel for an optional dedicated ILO port. Display port, VGA port on the bottom with removable panel for a serial port. Then there are 4 1 gigabit Ethernet ports, one of which can be shared with ILO. Lastly, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports. Embedded management on the system includes HPE Integrated Lights Out Standard for managing, alerting, reporting, and remote management of the system. For more advanced security features, there's HPE ILO Advanced Premium Security Edition. It offers advanced security features like automatic firmware recovery, runtime firmware verification, and secure erase. There's also a smart update manager for firmware and driver updates, and a mobile app for smartphones and tablets. If you need to kick it up a notch, there's HPE OneView Advanced, offering a template-driven way to provision, update, and integrate compute, storage, and networking infrastructure across several generations of servers. Inside the case, there are only 3 fans, 2 in front pulling fresh air in over the CPU and memory module slots, and a single fan right in the middle blowing air over the PCI slots and OCP mezzanine card holder area. The processor is either an Intel Core 6300P or Intel E2400 series CPU with 4, 6, or 8 cores and a TDP limit of 95 watts. And as I mentioned, there is also a single Pentium G7400 listed for the system. L3 cache is from 6 megabytes with that Pentium, and then from 12 to 24 megabytes with the other 2 CPU family options. All support DDR5 unbuffered UDIMMs that can operate at up to 4400 megatransfers per second. That said, memory speed is also dependent on the memory modules you install, as speed will default to the slowest performer between the memory modules and the CPU. With a total of 4 memory module slots, the system can be outfitted with up to 128 gigabytes of memory with 2 DIMMs per channel using 32 gigabyte memory modules in all slots. There is a single PCI 5.0 by 16 slot, an internal OCP storage controller slot, and a by 4 mezzanine card slot compatible with OCP 3.0 standards. That OCP card slot can be used for SmartArray or Smart HBA network interface controllers or for a tri-mode Gen 11 storage controller offering RAID functionality. You can also install one of those controllers in the PCI slot. The system can also accept a VROC key for limited RAID options with SSD SATA drive formats. As a small system, it has limited features, but still delivers integrated 1 gigabit Ethernet, which is definitely something that seems to be on its way out. The integrated part, well, and the fact that it's only 1 gigabit Ethernet. So with the HPE ProLiant DL20 Gen 11 server, you do get some of the little things that can help you make a qualified decision. There's no mention of GPU support on this system, but potentially, you could outfit it with a single T4 or A2 unit at 75 watts or less power consumption. Do hope you enjoyed this short overview of the Edge adjacent system. If you have any questions, I placed a few links in the description below, or you can use that one right there. ITCreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman, and thanks for watching.